Allah Almighty said in the Quran, "And indeed we have honored the children of Adam." But we often dishonor ourselves. And because we haven't actually fully grasped the concept of honor, we pursue it in dishonorable ways. Is honor derived from one's lineage, status, career, or appearance? Or is it deeper than that? إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ Allah honored mankind in several ways. This entire glorious universe that He's created functions in a way that benefits us. The sun, the moon, the clouds, the rain, the trees and the seas, nature and all of its seasons and colors, all function in harmony for the sake of our benefit.
وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمُ الشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرَ دَائِبَيْنِ وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمُ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارِ
Allah honored man with intellect and taught him how to use it, taught him how to write, taught him how to reason, taught him how to invent and construct, while defining for him his limits. And Allah honored man by sending him prophets and messengers with divine revelation to remind him of his purpose, teach him how to worship, beautify his character, and attain success in the hereafter. We did nothing to earn this position. As the angels were commanded to prostrate to Adam before he said, did, or achieved anything. But we have to ask ourselves, what must we do to enhance that honor? And what must we avoid that we not compromise it? Piety is here, the Prophet said. Through it, man becomes honored. Through it, our morals and character are made noble, and our affairs are set right. And the things that make people great outside of piety are not neglected through it, but only further embellished. As the Prophet, peace be upon him, said, "The best of you in the days of ignorance are the best of you in Islam, if you have understanding." Isn't it amazing that the ultimate measure of a man in the sight of God is the one thing that can't be seen by anyone else? And that is why Allah said immediately after that declaration that He is all-knowing and He is all-aware. As the Prophet, peace be upon him, said, "O people, verily Allah has removed the slogans of the days of ignorance from you and its reverence of its forefathers. So now there are two types of men. A man who is righteous, pious, and honorable in the sight of his Lord, and a man who is evil, wicked, and insignificant in the sight of his Lord. All of us are the children of Adam, and Allah created Adam from dirt." Once a man passed by the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, as he was sitting with his companions. And the Prophet asked, "What do you say about this man?" They said, "He is the most noble of people. If he proposes marriage, his proposal is accepted. And if he intercedes, his intercession is accepted. And if he speaks, people listen." The Prophet remained silent, and another man passed by. And so the Prophet asked again, "What do you say about this man?" They said, "O Messenger of Allah, this man is poor. If he proposes, he's rejected. And if he intercedes, his intercession is useless. And if he speaks, no one listens." The Prophet, peace be upon him, then said, "But this man is better than an earth full of men like the other man." It's amazing how the Prophet, peace be upon him, taught us to value people and to honor them despite what we may see of them. For it may be that Allah sees them in an entirely different light. And so just as Allah has honored man, He's commanded us to honor one another, not to belittle one another, nor harm one another in any way. For the Prophet, peace be upon him, forbade us from backbiting or abusing even the lowest of people. What then of disgracing an unknown friend of God? مَنْ عَادَ لِي وَلِيَّا فَقَدْ أَذَنْتُهُ بِالْحَرْبِ Since we don't know who they are, we honor each man and woman on the assumption that they may occupy a greater position in the sight of God than us. For the hearts of people are concealed from us, but the command to treat them with respect is as clear as night and day. O Allah, as you honored mankind by sending to it messengers, you honor this ummah in particular by sending to it Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Honor us again by granting us his companionship in the highest level of prayer.